वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंद समन्वितम् श्री चैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंदसहोदितम् श्री नंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणद्वयम् गोपीजन समयुक्त बिंदावन मनोहर वाचाकुवश कृपा सिंधु पति पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधवं वृंदावन तुलसीदेव वै पिया वै केशवस्य च स्नभक्तिपदे देवी सत्वत्वयी नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरे संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेश गौरी पत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरु भक्ति युक्तो भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोद्वरण्य धैयम् सदा परिभवग्नमविष्टदोहम् तीर्थास्पदम् शिव विरंचनुतम् शरण्यम् भीतात्तिहम् पनुतपाल भवद्दीपूतम् वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविंदम् यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमणिच्छटाय विस्फुरजित किमपि गपवधू स्वदर्श पूर्णानुरागरस सागर सारमूर्ति साराधिका मयि कदा कृपां करोषि श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद सियाद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकाभुधातु संकीर्तनैकवितरो कमलायताक्षो विश्वाम्बरो द्विजवरो जुगधर्मपालो वंदे जगत्प्रियकरु करुणाभुतारु हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरी निरंतर विभूषित वाम भागं नारायणो प्रियमनंग मदापहारं वाराणसीपुरपति भजवीशनाथं वागीशजुष्वदने लक्ष्मीर्यस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदय संवित् त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। यच्छक्तयो वदतां वदिनां वै विवाद संवाद भुवो भवन्ति कुर्वन्ति चैषां मुहुरात्ममोहम् तस्मै नमानन्तगुणाय भुवने। यच्छक्तयो वदतां वदिनां वै विवाद संवाद भुवो भवन्ति कुर्वन्ति चैषां मुहुरात्ममोहम् तस्मै नमानन्तगुणाय भुवने। गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड, विथ द हेल्प ऑफ दिस मेटेरियल ब्रेन इफ वी लाइक टू फाइंड सम फॉल इन अप्राकृत वैचित्र डाइवर्सिटी देन दिस इज सिंपली यू नो फुलिशनेस। गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड, विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस मेटेरियल ब्रेन इफ वी ट्राई टू फाइंड सम फॉल्ट इन अप्राकृत वैचित्र इन्फिनिटी डाइवर्सिटी इन दिस इन दैट अध्याय ग्रंथार्था इफ यू आर गोइंग टू फाइंड फॉल्ट देयर इट इज सिंपली फुलिशनेस नथिंग एल्स। बॉन्डेड सोल they are always busy with logical interpretation, but naturally there are four different kind of defects which is already a bonded soul always having this kind of four defects: brahmo pramat vipralipsa karnapatav karnapato brahmo pramat विप्रलिप्सा कर्ण पाटव। सो ए बॉन्डेड सोल कैन नेवर मेक मैन्युफैक्चर एनी सिद्धांत। इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर अ बॉन्डेड सोल टू मैन्युफैक्चर न्यू सिद्धांत। सिद्धांत इज इटर्नली प्रेजेंट, नोबडी कैन मैन्युफैक्चर सिद्धांत। इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू मैन्युफैक्चर सिद्धांत। सिद्धांत मीन इटर्नली इट इज प्रेजेंट देयर। Only by the mercy of Guru Kipa, Bhagavat Kipa, Siddhanti appears inside the heart of a pure devotees. Siddhanta is not, you know, gymnastic feats so that I can practice. Prabhupada speaking, Siddhanta is not gymnastic feats. We can try to, you know, in a gym, we can try to take barbell and try to get our muscle more, you know, tight, nice. Not possible. It's automatically coming here. Many examples there in the way of our Gauriya history, Gauriya Bhajan history. History I'm speaking by eternal history, not material history. There we find, so long as we are inclined unto lotus feet of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Guru Varga, we can understand everything. Everything mean? By the mercy, according to the mercy of Kripa, according to the degree of Kripa, we can understand, more or less. But when we get deviated from the track of Guru Vaishnava, then different kind of doubts and, you know, suspicion coming inside heart. Then we become busy with fighting. Logical altercation. Altercation always there. At the time of Prabhupada, we know it very well. Well established. Darshanik is a well established philosopher. Darshanik. By the mercy of Prabhupada, he used to write, read, speak very, very nice Siddhanta. Very, very nice Siddhanta. Even Prabhupada going to appreciate in front of Prabhupada, by the mercy of Prabhupada, he was habituated to speak nice philosophy, Gaudiya editor, all big, big pandits sitting with notebooks, everything, very famous. All Siddhanta coming inside heart by the mercy of Prabhupada. Our Guru Varga there in England, Prabhupada here, when they're supposed to speak anything, then by the mercy of Prabhupada, they get inspiration to speak. Actually, Mayavadi cannot believe it, this point, but those who are pure Vaishnava, they realize it. Gurudev gone, Prabhupada gone, they can feel power inside, heart, to understand all Siddhanta. It is possible. Prabhupada here, in Mayapur, Guru Varga gone to England or many different place, but by the mercy of Prabhupada, they are getting power. As and when I am going to ignore the power of Gurudev, when I want to project myself, I am the speaker. I have done everything. What Prabhupada done? Then everything finished. Follow. Many such cases happen. Previously, they used to follow Prabhupada, glorify Gauriya Math, their glories, you know, transcendental glories. After that, ignore. No, that's useless. They fall down. They want to prove that it is, we are powerful, that's why we have done. It is called Mayavad. To depend upon the own power, efficiency, power, everything is called Mayavad. Yesterday I was also discussing that more or less we are contaminated with Manava. Something we believe, something we don't believe, that is the point. Actually, now point is there. When they get deviated from Prabhupada, same man, by the mercy of Prabhupada, they are writing so nice Siddhanta, inconceivable. Prabhupada sending in Calcutta University Hall to speak, give lecture on Radhavan's, so important, you know, points, you know, Gauriya Darshan, they are speaking. But as and when they get defeated from Prabhupada, they fall down, they cannot discover this situation, they are writing all rubbish. Same man, by the mercy of Prabhupada writing this, now when deviated from the track of Prabhupada writing all rubbish. Useless. But volumes of book he is writing. All useless. All against Gauriya Math, all against Harinam Mahamantra, all against Gauriya ideology, against Prabhupada. Even not going to identify who is Gurudev. Kesava Goswami Maharaj writing, we are less interested to hear and read this kind of book. Because first of all, we like to know who is the Gurudev of Subodh Ghosh. Subhatsa. Who is the Gurudev of Subhatsa? First of all, we like to know. Because in spiritual line, everything we are doing by the power of Guru. We cannot ignore Guru. First and foremost point. This way, we never try to take the help of our, you know, educational power or money power, manpower, nothing. We only want to depend upon the kripa of Supreme Lord, Guru Varga and Supreme Lord, to understand this very, very delicate, intricate tattva, jiva tattva. Yesterday I was discussing that all diversity, anything, whatever you can see, you cannot see, you can conceive, you cannot conceive, all under the category of Adyaya and Tattva. Unique Adyaya and Tattva. Now point is that, if at all Supreme Lord Sri Krishna is Adyaya and Tattva, then all countless diversities expressed by Him, either in this material world, or there in this transcendental world, surely can come under the category of Adhyayan Tattva. Because without Adhyayan Tattva, nothing there. Without Adhyayan Tattva, nothing there. But that doesn't mean we can conclude like Mayavadi. Adhyayan Tattva is not, you know, neutral gender. Prabhupada speaking, Adhyayan Tattva means Adhyayan Tattva full of variety, infinity variety there. If we cannot understand Shakti Tattva, because so long as Shakti Tattva is not expressed, then we cannot say anything. When Bhagavan going to express his desire to play with Shakti Tattva, then and only then we can find diversity. Like Veda Stuti, I already told. Huh? Veda Stuti. Jaya 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 yama jita dosa krivita guna tamasi yadatmana samabharudva samastabhaga aga yaga dhoko samakila sakta babodhakati. This sloka, very nice. He Bhagavan, when you are going to withdraw all your sakti inside you, then nothing visible. Bijit, follow. But when you are going to play with Shakti, then different kind of leelas and sistri, you know. So everything ultimately under the category of Adhyayan Tattva, but still we cannot deny Shakti Tattva. Mayavadi, they are going to deny Shakti Tattva. They think if we are at all going to confess this Shakti Tattva, then our Adhyayan Tattva cannot stand. They think so. But our Gauriya Siddhanta, we know Achinta Vedavet Tattva, inconceivable Tattva, simultaneously the same and different from Supreme Lord. Achinta Vedavet. Achinta, this word sometimes we are explaining inconceivable. We are explaining this way, inconceivable. We cannot understand this much. But this achinta, this word, not only if we say that now it is not possible to understand. But still it is possible to understand. If not understand, then why you are trying bhajan? What you can get? If there is no target in our life, that we can go to serve Supreme Lord there, if there is no target, nothing at all, aimless bhajan, aimless any work is useless. We have a strong faith in Guru Bhargava. I mean should have some strong faith. We believe that after this life, we can get the scope to serve. This kind of untired effort should come inside our heart. All his inspiration can come. In Upadeshamrita, Rupa Goswami Pad writing, but someday I can explain. Utsahat ischat dajjat tat tat karma pavartanat. If there is no inspiration, follow. If I am not getting any inspiration, how I can do? Every day coming like new day, it is covered up in a golden, you know, envelope. The day I am opening and going to see new thing opening daily. Enthusiastic bhajan. If I feel bored, then there must be some aparad. In bhajan, there is no question of boredness. No, we can never feel bored. Every day we have the enthusiastic power. Well, new power here. Follow. This untiring effort, this untiring endeavor, enthusiastic energy, follow, perseverance, is the root cause of our success. Try to understand. Now, all infinity diversity, be it in material world and transcendental world, all under the category of Adhyayan Tattva. Only the difference is there in Nitya Jagat, eternal Jagat, their diversity is eternally present, and here diversity, though there, it get destroyed. Follow. Mahaprabhu giving argument to Prabodhananda Saraswat Prakasananda that it is not this material world is not false. It is not dream. I am seeing everything, but it can get destroyed. This much I can say. It is visible, it is true. But Maya is also eternally present. We cannot see. That is a problem. So all different kind of diversity, we must confess. It is under the category of Adhyayan Tattva. No doubt in it. He who is all-powerful, omnipresent, everything is possible for Him. We should not express any doubt in it. All material conception about beginning, middle or end, past, present and future, all applicable here in this material world. But it is not applicable there in transcendental world. I can, time factor of Prakita Samaya, when I can discuss, then I can discuss. Now, first of all, we will have to understand very carefully that there is no necessity. Adhyaya Gyantata Brahma Tattva is saturated. Yesterday I was discussing from Vedanta. Na prayano bhattadhikaranam. Under this category, I was discussing na prayano bhattvat. I can start discussing this point, but first of all I like to discuss one point. Many from different angle we will have to discuss this point, otherwise we cannot understand. Why karma is anadi? First of all, you have to get answer from Vedanta everywhere. And after that I can simultaneously discuss this, because it will link with this point. Why karma is anadi? That is the main point. Why karma is anadi? The prime cause of all karma. Be careful, I am going to discuss everything under the guidance of Baladev Vidyabhushan, Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad, Jiva Goswami Pad, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada or Keshav Goswami, all our Guru Varga. Follow. Don't forget this point. So, the prime cause of all karma is the desire to execute such karma. Samasta karmer mool karma basana, desire. The prime cause of all karma is the desire to execute such karma. Avidya, ignorance, is the root cause of this material desire. And is defined as forgetfulness of the truth that I am the eternal servitor of Krishna. Jeev Krishna Das Taha Bhuli Gelo is forgetfulness. Follow. I already told many times, Vidya and Avidya both eternally present. Not that Avidya, just now Bhagavan going to get, not that. Vidya and Avidya both there. Atma, Chidatma, Chit particle Atma is Anandamay, Chit particle Atma is Ganamay, full of knowledge. Anandamay, Ganamay, and Chinmay. same qualitatively all same like Bhagavan. Qualitatively all same like Bhagavan. Bhagavan Anandamay, Gyanamay, Anandamay, Chinmay. Follow. Abhidya and Vidya, both eternally present in Jiva, not that only Vidya. So the prime cause of all karma is the desire to execute such karma, and also Abhidya, ignorance, is the root of this material desire and is defined, explained as forgetfulness of this truth that I am the eternal servitor of Sri Krishna. This Abhidya did not suddenly sprout out of within the time span of material universal creation. Many times Prabhupada going to speak this way, scientific way, because ordinary people, they cannot go up to that far. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur bound to speak this way. How Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, why karma is anadi? Because there is no time period can be found within the framework of this material time. But if I put question in front of you, how it is possible? Because material time period and aprakita time, there is two factor of time. One is material time, another is aprakita time. If Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to speak this way, repeatedly, we cannot find the beginning of point within the framework of material, within the framework of this material time period. That surely means Bhaktivinoda Thakur want to speak. If material time we cannot find in the beginning, then surely it is there, eternally present. Logic, simple logic. Follow, we cannot understand eternal, we can speak, but we cannot realize. We cannot realize. I can give version of what Bhaktivinoda Thakur want to speak. All whenever we are going to speak, that Bhagavan Govinda is Adi, from Govinda, Gauranga, divide into two parts, Radha Govinda, Radha Govinda unified, Krishna. Now when Krishna is first, Radha Krishna is first, or Gaur first. Follow. It's simply foolish. This argument we cannot, is useless. Because by Chit Samadhi, if I can go on doing bhajan in such a way, which is going to touch the heart of Krishna. If we are going to do bhajan in such a way, that bhajan going to touch the heart of Krishna. Krishna is bound to respond. Krishna is bound to accept me. In that case, very easily, without any argument, I can understand what is what. There in Chinmay Jagat. Because it is impossible to understand. How we can understand? Nobody can understand. Every time we are speaking this way, there is no other way. Whenever we speak that from Gaur Radha Govinda Kami, Radha Govinda from Radha Govinda unified Gaur Kami, Arya Maharaj, Anadi Radhi Govinda, okay. But what is the beginning point? Always finite conception working in our brain. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, the urine and stool of this material world conception. Our dirty stool and urine conception of this material world always going to put us in trouble. Whenever we say this dham coming from Nityananda, this, then automatically one conception is start. Coming from Nityananda is starting, surely. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, so long as we are busy with material things, material time, material everything, never we can understand. If I can do bhajan in such a way, Krishna can, that bhajan can touch the heart of Krishna, Krishna can accept me, then and only then it is possible to understand what is what, then aprakriti jagat. Otherwise, some indication can be given. Sukadeva Goswami also in Bhagavatam giving some indication. Hey Rajan, in an eternal world, what is there in eternal world, it is impossible for everybody to understand. So only I can give indication like this, like bot, in Sanskrit bot, you know, like this you can see. But we cannot say it is just like this, this much we can say. So, actually, Vidya and Avidya always eternally present. Sometime Vidya going to express inside heart, sometime Avidya going to express. It depends upon the situation. It depends upon the situation of Jiva. So, Avidya ignorance, this root of the materialism. And also we know Avidya coming from this single point to forget Krishna. Our forgetfulness of this truth that we are the eternal servant of Krishna. Avidya did not suddenly sprout out within the time span of this material universal creation. The seat of this root of karma originates in the matrix of the tatastha position of jiva at the junction at the juncture of the material and spiritual creation. Since the absolute of since the source of karma is thus untraceable, we cannot find out within the mundane time of this material world, karma is said to be anadi, this much. So if we cannot find any beginning within the time period of the material creation, then surely it indicates that eternally present. Then how we cannot find? Then how we cannot find? That is the main question. This is the main question. What is the difference between Maya and Avidya? Maya is a Shakti of Sri Krishna. Though her, Maya is a Shakti of Sri Krishna. Through her, by the help of this Maya, Krishna has created the material cosmos. In Brahma Sangita also many times I told, you can remember, Srishti Sriti Pralaya Sadhana Saktirika Chayeva Jasya Bhavanani Vivarti Durga Icchanu Rupam Apiya Chashtate Sa Govindam Adi Purusham Tamaham Bajami. You can remember, no? I told many times. Yeah. Maya is the Shakti. By the help of this Maya, Bhagavan has created this material cosmos with the intention of, you know, Maya is Shakti, Brahmanda Srishti, and to rectify those, you know, to give treatment to those bonded souls. And also, Krishna is with playing mood. Many times I was told, always unending sporting moods is there, playing mood. All averse jivas, bahirmukh jivas, to rectify them. New Krishna is always expecting. Krishna is always expecting joy, though Krishna is satisfied, all the time saturated. Still Krishna is expecting new jib can come, new jib can come and play with me. Always Krishna expecting new jib can come and play with me. Why not? So by the help of Maya, material Maya, Bhagavan has created this material world. Maya has two, you know, function, vritti. One is avidya, another is pradhan. Pradhan is a term before creation, the ingredients. Avidya is related to jiva nishtha. It is related to jiva, going to envelop jiva. And pradhan is related to ingredients, material ingredients, by the help of which this whole world created. Follow what I say. Sometime, why I started with the sloka, I can jatsakta yuvadatam vadidam vai vivadu sangvadu bhubu bhavanti kurvanti chaisam muhuratmamu. Why I told? Because always fighting going on between two pandit or sadhu all the time. They cannot come into a proper conclusion. It is the magic spell of Maya. Follow. This is sometimes somebody in logic, you can find that a tree is fast or seed is fast. A tree is fast or seed is fast. Is only fighting going on, no solution coming. Because it is about aprakita jagat, logical interpretation cannot stand. Seed is fast or, Arya Maharaj, everything is possible for Sri Krishna. Especially at the time of pralaya, when there is nothing, all around darkness, nothing. Pralaya, total pralaya. Pralaya also, different kind of pralayas are there. Prakritik pralaya, naimittik pralaya, nitya naimittik pralaya, different kind of pralayas are there. But I mean to say, at the time of pralaya, everything we find in the form of seed inside Mahavishnu. Also, I can give another example about Satyabrata king. One king, his name is Satyabrata. In Bhagavatam, I already discussed many times. Satyabrata, you know, went to take bath in Kritamala river. There in hand, one very small fish coming. And the king going to throw. Useless. I am doing japa and, you know, chanting, guide. One fish coming. When Satyabrata king, Kritamala Nadi, river name is Kritamala. Then the fish speaking, oh king, don't throw me inside water. I am very fearful about this, you know, aquatic animals going to swallow me. What is this? The small fish speaking. Okay. Then the king going to save that fish inside his kumandal. Kumandal, you know, water pot, one sannyasi sadhu having. After that, when, you know, that king coming into palace, oh king, I cannot manage to stay here, it is too small for me. What is this? I am growing now. After, okay. Then you arrange my big place for staying. This small flat is not available, you know, suitable for me. After that, the king going to arrange one big place. After that, a pond. And even in pond, not possible. King, please arrange big. After, what is this? After this, a river. After this, king, it is not. What happens? Who are you? Actually, Matsya Avatar, Bhagavan, playing with Satyabrata. And what I mean to say, that is very important, that fish, Matsya Avatar going to give indication, instruction to king. Oh king, within 7 days from today, the whole world going to be inundated by the flood, you know, big pralaya. So you try to, you know, save all seeds and everything. And you can find in pralaya one boat can be there, and I can guide that port boat. You can tie with my hull there on head. I know. You can tie the rope, and in Pralaikal I can travel with you. But please, you try to get all seat with you. And Saptarshi, seven rishis can be there with you in Pralaikal. Now, what my point is that is common sense. When no creation is there, then all srishti were gone. If you try to discuss the srishti tattva, you can say one by one when unfolding from pradhan one by one unfolding srishti, and when going to get destroyed, then one by collapse on each other one by one, and one by one collapse, and finally going to come in a very very fine form all. So naturally in pralaya we cannot expect all creation. It is there in fine form. Even all jivas also, the material, those jiva abundant souls, they are also taking, you know, place there in inside by the annihilation exhalation. Jashaika nisheshito kalam athavalambo jiv. Follow this sloka, you know. Jashaika nisheshito kalam athavalambo jivanti loma vilaja jagadannanatha Vishnuro mahanaso iho yasso kalavishesho govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami. This way you can find. So seed is first and tree is for useless fighting. Try to satisfy Supreme Lord by seva. All useless. Try to satisfy Bhagavan by seva. This is the only way. This much. And Bhagavan, when going to accept you, then you can understand everything. Many times you know this is discussion. Nayam atma pravachana nilabhya na medhaya na bahuna sitena jam eva esha tena labhya. Jam eva esha vrinite tena labhya. When Supreme Lord going to accept you, okay, you come, you are mine. Tumi to amar, ami to tomar, I am your, you are mine. Is the eternal relationship. What is this material world? What is appearances? What is, you know, diversity going to put me in trouble? Because I don't understand Adhyaya Granthatva. If I fail to understand, realize this point from heart, all belonging to this Adhyaya Granthatva, but still, diversity is there. This way actually, avidya is related to jiva and pradhan is related to material ingredients. And how creation going on day by day, I can, you know, when I already discussed at the time of Bhagavad discourse, how srishti came, pradhan going to get separated, how from then, you know, all creation coming, I already discussed. Now karma anadi. This point is very typical point. We don't like to believe. So how karma anadi? How karma anadi? You are speaking okay, but because we know, and the categories of jivas also I can discuss. How many categories of jivas? Those from Balaram Sankarshan, some jivas coming. Jivas are there. And from Tatasya Sakti there, from Brahmajyoti also some, and who coming from Brahmajyoti, who going there, all different I can discuss. It will take long time, not a matter of joke, that within two words you can finish and close the chapter. From different angle we will have to discuss this point to get satisfaction. Follow what I say. If we say Bhagavan going to create bonded soul, then we are going to speak Bhagavan is selfish, partiality. Why is because bonded soul they are suffering, and why is it? But we cannot blame Supreme Lord. That the point is very important. From Vedanta we will have to discuss. Why and how? Why and how we cannot blame Supreme Lord at all? What can be the reason? And Anadi Bahirmukh, how? Only we hear Anadi Bahirmukh, Anadi Bahirmukh. How? We like to understand. So I like to discuss some point first, then again I go to my original discussion. Na prayojana vattvat. First point is as Brahma is saturated, purna vastu, and Bhagavan is not failing in his, then why should he go for, why can Bhagavan take trouble to and for this creation? What necessary? When I speak this sutra from Vedanta, it is 2.132. Second part, first chapter, 32 sutra. Na prayojana vattvat. Na mean no. No necessity there. Without any reason. Are you, Maharaj, without any reason, even foolish cannot do. Without any reason, foolish also cannot do. Why you can so? Why you can say like that? We are not ready to believe it. In logic, Niti Shastra also is written, prayanam anuddisho mandadhir opi na pavartati. Prayanam anuddisho, without any necessity, without any utility, who is going to do? Even in foolish also cannot, don't like to do. Follow. Any meaning we are going to understand from Shastra, two procedures there. I already discussed yesterday, Ganga, Yam, Ghosapalli. One village is there on Ganga or in Ganga. Impossible. Then we'll have to play our brain. Ganga, Yam, Ghosapalli, it means at the bank of Ganga. This, okay. I mean, two procedures, Mahaprabhu speaking. One is Avida, one is Lakshana. Lakshana means by symptom. Follow. Lakshana means symptom. By the Lakshana. Symptom here. Follow. From long distance I am watching one red flag. Red flag means usually it is, maybe some temple is there. It seems so. Say it's assumption. Lakshana vritti. But all the time we cannot apply this procedure. It is not good. Mahaprabhu, that's why, wanted to speak to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, Sarvabhauma. When the meaning is itself clear to me, Sarvabhauma, when the meaning of Sutra, Vedanta is clear to me, why should I go bent way, zigzag way? What do you mean? I mean to say, whenever you are speaking any Vedanta Sutra, I can clearly understand. But you are going to explain in such a way, I become puzzled. Oh my God! What do you mean? I thought I am teaching you. Now I think you are teaching me. You know, he is going to give me teaching the Supreme Lord. Eh? Mm. Now this no prayojana vattvat, this means, first of all, there is no, one negative point. Nished, no. So actually, there is no prayojana vattvat, pravrittir no pajujyate. Somebody going to speak, Arey Maharaj, Bhagavan is purna kam, purna sapurna madayu purna meva avasiswati, om purna purna madho. This sloka we know. So why should Bhagavan take trouble to go for creation? What do you say? If somebody going to, you know, start argument. Bhagavan purnaka. Atoev, that is why there is no necessity. So why should Bhagavan take trouble to create this material world? So we cannot find any reason. Now question coming. What can be the reason? There must be some reason, but what can be the reason? That reason we like to trace out. The answer is that Brahma Purnakam. You know, Brahma Purnakam, that's why Bhagavan cannot feel any necessary to go for creation. Here in this material world, we can find two things. Sometimes somebody going to do something for himself, he is feeling necessary to do it, and sometimes he is going to feel necessary for others. He is going to do something for others. That two, you know, pravritti brahma. But these two reasons not applicable for Brahma, because Brahma is purna. And for others mean dual conception. For whom? There is no creation. Why should this question is not applicable? Follow. This way, some point coming. Negative point. Sometimes some powerful man, rich man, going to show compassion to poor man for their disease, for their poverty. This can be there. But why Ishwar can take trouble that way? That is the main reason. Because we know Purna Madaha Purna Midam Purnat Purna Mudachate. Follow. Ishopanishad, you can find this sloka on Brihad Aranyak also. In Brihad Aranyak Upanishad also you can find this. What is that? Purna Madaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachati Purnasa Purnamadaya Purnameva Avashishvati. Follow. So we cannot find any reason here. Why Bhagavan can go for creation, and with creation there is so many jivas that and are taking trouble, and what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is going to answer, I can discuss. Then for this reason, what can be the reason? Then the next sloka, there is written, Lokovattu lila kaivalyam. Lokovattu lila kaivalyam. This sloka, now we are going to discuss to understand the real meaning for why Bhagavan going to take trouble to create this material world. One kind of playing. Is one kind of playing, lila. That's why in the sutra, next sutra, Lokovattu lila kaivalyam. So when the first party going to argue, there is no necessity. So why Bhagavan take trouble? Then the second party going to get answer. What can be the reason? Sometimes we see sukhanmatto. Sometimes somebody become so happy. You know, follow. In bhajan also, sometimes doing bhajan, they become very happy, start dancing. Follow. Bhagavan alone dancing in forest. Follow. Radharani asking, Lalita, where from you are coming? Well, I am coming from that forest. You see Krishna there? Yes, he is in that forest. What he is doing? He is dancing. Who is Guru? You. Hari? Like fanatic man. So, you see, small boys, they are playing. There is no profit and loss account. Why small boys, they are playing? What can be the reason? Very small boys. They are playing. There is no profit and loss account. What can be there? In Narayan Sangita also it is written, Bhagavan not going to do anything, you know, for any reason. Because Sarupananda, Bhagavan is full of Sarupananda. It is impossible for you all to understand this point. Because such a sensitive point, Bhagavan is full of ananda, and Bhagavan is full of ananda, overflowing. When ananda overflowing, then you start dancing. Follow what I say. Narayana Sanga is speaking, Bhagavan is full of sarupananda, overflowing, overflowing, overflowing. No place to keep. Then automatically Bhagavan, you know, can do something which is, as per your opinion, is unusual. Jaik one matto bhakti mad, without any reason dancing. So, purno madaha purnamidam purnat purnamudachate purnam anandamai hari. Actually, there is no necessity. Whereas we know, mukta purush, many bhajansil purush mukta kam. So, Bhagavan is purna kam, what can be doubt? What doubt can be there? We know those who are doing bhajan, they become purna kam. Madhavendra Puripad, not expecting anything, purna kam. All is satisfied, not even asking any milk. Shukdev Goswami, nothing. They are purna kam, they are satisfied in themselves. So if Bhagavan is purna kam, what can be doubt there? So, Mundak Upanishad, going to put question, kas priheti, what can be the desire? Mundak Upanishad going to speak. Then Narayana was speaking, Bhagavan not going to do, we are doing something, there can be some root, there can be some cause behind it, anything we are doing. Without any cause, we are not doing anything. But it is not applicable for Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord is full of Sarupananda. Sukhanumatto, when one mad is full of happiness, full of happiness, start dancing. Follow, what can be the reason? Is the expression of his joy. Similarly, Parameshwar also going to do this kind of leela without any profit and loss account. So, Sarupananda overflowing, so Bhagavan doing. So this way Bhagavan doing, actually there is no reason, but still there is, you know, he is feeling nasal. Follow. That day, yesterday I was discussing, that no reason, but still Bhagavan doing. Purna anandamaya vastu Bhagavan, purna kam, apto kam, purna kam, is going to create this material world full of diversity. You can see the color of different birds. You see the color of trees and planet, you know, plants, fruits and flowers. If you have any common sense, you can understand Bhagavan is so full of rasa. Bhagavan is full of rasa, rasik. Eh? Bhagavan is so rasik. Full of rasa, is going to create this, you know, infinity diversity. Oh my God. Bhagavan is rasik, topmost engineer, you know, creating so many things. This way. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving some answer actually. So there can be Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving some answer. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Krishna is Karunamaya. Krishna is Karunamaya. But you should not forget, Krishna is also Lilamai. Krishna is Karunamai, but he is also Lilamai. Dynamic and eternally engages in pastimes. With the view that the jiva could become an active partner for his various leelas. I already told, na? Krishna is saturated, but still expecting. New jiva can come and play with me. Is coming. So, Krishna is Karunamaya, but you should remember also that Krishna is also Lilamaya. Dynamic and eternally engages in pastimes, with the view that the jiva could become an active partner for his various leelas. The Supreme Lord has made this jiva versatile and acceptable of rising from her humble position as a marginal being to the soaring heights of Mahabhava. From this low position, Krishna like to take jiva up to that Mahabhava. Is possibility Krishna going to keep the possibility and going to watch what is the desire of jiva? Because free will given as a jewel, you know. So, in this manner, you know, this Lord has made that her versatile and capable of rising from her humble position as a marginal being to the soaring heights of Mahabhava, the highest spiritual consciousness, which is unlimited and transcendental. To make the jiva strongly determined and facilitate her ascension to the divine position, the Lord has also created the various levels of material energies. Energy from gross matter up to, you know, ahankara absiding, which reaches its depth with misidentification with matter. Should the jiva choose the path of material progress, the inert matter, you know, present practically insurmountable obstacles. There is countless obstacles created in the jiva's search for the supreme happiness. He'll have to do. Follow. The jiva who are moving down to this material entanglements, seeking only to satisfy their senses, are divorced from their sarupa, then avidya going to act, thus increasingly, you know, distance themselves from Supreme Lord. They become increasingly, you know, depraved. But the infinitely compassionate Lord, with his transcendental abode and eternal associates, descends to earth and appears before them, jivas, in person to offer them the opportunity of elevation to the highest spiritual distinction. The jivas who take this opportunity to elevate themselves gradually rise to the transcendental realm and acquire the same position as the Nitya Parsadas. Follow. So, Lokabhattu Lila Kaivalyam. This loka, Lokabhattu. Bhat mean comparative statement. It is like ordinary human being they are doing. Lokabhattu Lila Kaivalyam. It is like, but actually material people, we cannot compare Supreme Lord with material people. But it is comparative statement. Is it like Lokabhattu? No, no, like Lila Kaivalyam. Some speciality is there also. So, Bhagavan, though actually there is no necessity for Bhagavan to create this material world, still Bhagavan out of his, you know, Sarupananda, like one people full of enjoyment, sometimes dancing, this way. This way, actually, example given. And now, actually, question coming. It is second part, first chapter, 34 sloka. Already in the letter, I already read, but the sloka was not there written. There is no partiality of Bhagavan Brahma in his creation. Vaishamma nirghinneti adhikaranam. In this creation, if you go on discussing, then we can find that automatically we, as if Bhagavan is responsible. But ultimately we can see through our discussion that Bhagavan is not at all responsible. Vaishamma nirghinne na sapekshatvat tathahi darsayati. Vaishamma nirghinne na sapekshatvat tathahi darsayati. Follow. If we take it granted, first question, Bhagavan is the creator or not? Is Brahma, is Jagatkarta? Is then there some question coming? What is that? If Brahma is going to create, he is the creator, then automatically somebody can put this question, then this kind of partiality, you know, is not good on the part of Bhagavan. That's why they are giving answer. Brahma, if Karta is a creator, you know, we cannot admit this point. It is not acceptable. Though Bhagavan is a creator, we cannot say Bhagavan is heartless, Bhagavan has some personality. We cannot say. Follow. Why? Well, it is written, Vaishamma nirghinne na sapekshatvat tathahi darsayati. Sapekshatvat, there is no reason for why you can say Bhagavan is going to show partiality. Srishtikarta going to depend upon the karma of jiva. So according to that, they are taking birth. Bhagavan has nothing to blame. तथा ही दर्शनात् अकॉर्डिंग टू कर्म भगवान कैन गिव फ्रूट्स इन श्रुति वेनो एष एव साधु कर्म कारयति त्वं दिस वे सो मेनी पॉजिटिव पॉइंट यू कैन फाइंड द भगवान गोइंग टू गिव रिजल्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू कर्म क्रिएटर ब्रह्म भगवान गोइंग टू डिपेंड अपॉन द कर्म ऑफ जीवा अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट सृष्टिकर्ता द क्रिएटर यू नो डिपेंडिंग अपॉन देयर इंडिविजुअल कर्म अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट ही इज गोइंग टू क्रिएट फॉलो नाउ अनदर पॉइंट कमिंग If Bhagavan going to depend upon the karma of jiva, prani, you know, living entity, then Bhagavan is not Bhagavan doing according to karma or neutrally Bhagavan doing. Bhagavan going to create this world according to the karma of jivas, creating this world. Or standing on neutral platform. What is this? Jodi, if we are going to speak that Bhagavan is going to depend upon the karma of all jivas, then some group going to speak, then surely he is not Ishwar, because he is, we know, Sarat, Savigya Sarat, he is omnipresent. Why he should depend upon the karma of jiva? Or if we can speak another way, that Bhagavan is neutral of any karma. Bhagavan not depending on any karma on jiva is going to create. Then question coming, then surely Bhagavan has some partiality and some heartlessness can touch. Follow. If Bhagavan going to create this world, standing on neutral platform, not depending upon the karma of jiva, then automatically we are speaking, then why you are going to put all jivas in trouble? Surely you are not, you have some partiality, you are heartless. This kind of problem coming. Follow. Now, Vedabhyas actually, through this sutra, Bhagavan, Vedabhyas is going to give answer, Vaishamma nairghinne na sapekha tvat tatahi darshayati. Then he is going to give answer, no. न सापेक्षत्वात् बिकॉज ही इज नॉट पर्सनैलिटी इज नॉट गोइंग टू शो इन पर्सनैलिटी ही इज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन कर्म सृष्टि इज गोइंग टू गिव क्रिएट दिस क्रिएशन इट इज नॉट एट ऑल यू नो यू कैन नॉट फाइंड एनी फॉल्ट हियर बिकॉज If Bhagavan not going to give result according to individual karma of jiva, in that case partiality can come. And if somebody say, then in that case Bhagavan is Sarat, Savigya Sarat, is all powerful. Why? That then, you know, Baladev Vidyavasana speaking, that king, you cannot say that Bhagavan giving result according to karma, that's why he is not Bhagavan. Bhagavan is Sarat, almighty, powerful, he can do anything. You cannot speak this. Baladev Buddha was speaking, like king going to give result to his servants according to their karma fall. But for that you cannot say that king is not king. Follow. About Ishvara, now question coming, if jivas, they are going to do karma according to their previous karma fall, then how we can say Bhagavan is almighty, full Bhagavan is a full controller, Bhagavan is the ultimate controller? How we can say? Because from Bhagavatam we also know Bhagavan Sri Krishna and Balaram speaking to Nanda Upananda, everybody, before Govardhan Puja. Karmana jayate jantu karma naiva praliyate sukham dukham bhayam khemam karma naiva vipaddhati. We find this one. Karmana jayate jantu karma naiva praliyate sukham dukham bhayam khemam karma naiva avipaddhati. There also Bhagavan speaking this way. Dehanu chavachanu jantuhu prapot srijati karmana shatru mitto mudasinaha karmaiva guru rishwaraha. Same chapter, 10th canto, 24th chapter. Also Nagapatni, at the time of, you know, Kaliya Daman, we did Kaliya Patni, all the wives of Kaliya speaking. Najohi dando krito kilvise asmin stavavataraha kalanigrahayo ripoho sutanam upi tullo drishter dhatse damam palamevanusasanam. Kaliya Patni, they are speaking, O Prabhu, you are giving result according to karma of jiva, so no, you are not responsible, actually. Jivas are there again, the karma fall. Now, point is that Bhagavan is all-powerful, super-controller. Then why karma, we can say the jivas doing karma, they are getting result. How we can trace out Bhagavan is super-controller? Example here given by Baladev Vidyavasan about Ishvara, we can give the example of rain. Pajanna means Pajanna. Pajanna means actually, you know, Brishti, rain, Meg, Pajanna Meg. Meg means cloud. If cloud is not there, then there is no possibility of any rain. Follow what I say. If cloud is not there, then there is no possibility of any rain. And if there is no possibility of any rain, there can be some seed already you put into ground. Bow. Maybe you have already somebody going to bow some seed into field, but there is no rain, then sprout cannot come. Follow what I say. So about this, it is written, ultimately Bhagavan is not, you know, nādatya kasyacit pāpam na caiva sukritim vibhum agyaneno avritam jñānam tenam yanti yantavah. Ultimate controller you can find, controlling is in the hand of Bhagavan. Jiva unnecessarily going to suffer, their karma fall. Karta aham ityamandati, I am doership, that's why they are suffering. By the controlling power and said hand of Bhagavan. Because without rain, karma seed is already there. Eternally, jivas, you know, rotating, you know, according to karma. But sprout cannot come. Follow. Like there can be some seed in the field, but without rain, you cannot expect sprout. Similarly, karma anadi traveling with jiva, but without the help of power of Supreme Lord, karma phal you cannot get. Follow. Karma phal in the hand of Supreme Lord, because the example already I give, without rain, sprout cannot come. Karma bijis all can be there. So without the help of Supreme Lord, jiva karma fall, a sprout cannot come out. And if karma fall not coming out, then karma fall rotating one by one. If karma fall is not there, so Supreme Lord has his, you know, liberty in this point. That's why sometimes Bhagavan says, "Oh, I am everywhere, but I am nowhere." Contradictory point, na? I am everywhere, I am nowhere. Ami to jagate boshi jagat amache. I am here in all universe, but again opposite thing Bhagavan says, "Ami to jagate boshi jagat amache." I am here, you can find me here in material world everywhere. Jagat is there in me. Second point, ami to jagate boshi jagat amate. Second point, just opposite. Nahami nami jagate boshi na jagat amate. This material was not inside me, not at all, and I am also not there. So all contradictory points can get full adjustment. All proper adjustment there for Supreme Lord, Supreme Divinity, in eternal world, everything possible. Bhagavan speaking, I am everywhere in this material and the whole world is there in me. Adhyasana speaking, nothing there in me. I am nowhere. Ami to jagate boshi jagat amate. Na ami jagate boshi na jagat amate. Totally opposite thing. So this way actually, we find it is possible. It is possible that according to karma they are actually there. So second sloka actually we find Bhagavan has no partiality at all. Since now how karma anadi, this answer you are going to get, no karma vibhagaditi chet nanaditvat, no karma vibhagya. Here it is written, no karma vibhagaditi chet nanaditvat. Maharaj, first point is that we hear many time, originally there was Brahma, again coming this time factor. Originally there was only Brahma, nothing was there. We find from Upanishad. There was no division of any karma. So how do karma become anadi? Follow what I say. The 35 number, the next slok going to give answer. That if there is no division of karma, there is only Brahma. If we are going to say Bhagavan going to give result according to karma fall of jivas or this creation material, still we cannot avoid this allegation. Bhagavan is surely having some partiality. Why? Karma abhivagat. There was no division of karma. Follow. Srishti, before this material creation, there is only Brahma. We hear all the time from Upanishad. So surely Bhagavan has partiality. Otherwise, why Jiva is going to, you know, sub devata, demigods also, they are enjoying something. And in material we find some Jivas are enjoying something, some Jivas suffering. Why? Surely Bhagavan has some partiality. This kind of problem. Now to give answer, Vyasadeva Goswami writing this sloka, you know, no karma abhivagat iti chet nanaditvat. We are going to give your objection, Honor. We cannot say the Bhagavan has partiality. Then you will have to give document. Why not Bhagavan? You know, because according to karma fall, Bhagavan giving. If we understand, then question coming, if karma was not there, Brahma was there, then we surely Bhagavan is responsible, Your Honor. So this way argument going on. Now objection coming, according to karma division, Bhagavan giving results, still Bhagavan cannot pass away. There is some, you know, objection we have. Because nothing separate existence is not there. All you already told Adyaya Gyantattva, without Brahma, the existence of karma, how can be there? From Brahma, separate existence of karma, satta, cannot be there. Because we know from Upanishad, sadevo shommad vajaya, sadevo shommedam agra asid. In Upanishad, Shruti, we know, sadevo shommedam agra asid. From Brahma, there was no separate existence of nothing. Nothing was there. Brahma ita prithak bhuto karmer patiti, we cannot find. So how we can understand? Then answer giving, then here, you know, Govinda Vasya, Baladev Vidyavasana speaking, giving the document. The karma and khetragya jiva. Khetragya means field. In Gita also, khetra khetragya, field. You know, this body is like field where Gurudev is going to give seed, you know, we are going to give water and, you know, sunlight like Sankirtan, Nam Sankirtan, everything, the sprout can come, Bhakti Lata Beach, same way. Baladev Vidyavasana speaking, karma and khetragya jiva. They are also as well as Brahma. They are anadi. Baladev Vidyavasana going to prove that not only this is, you know, but also Brahma is, you know, eternally present, but karma and jiva also eternally present. There is no trace out of any beginning. Karma and khetragya jiva, all jivas, they are anadi, like Brahma. It is already said in Shastra. So, Brahma was only there. Nothing was there. Not that. Brahma was there. Karma was eternally present there. Brahma is eternally present there. Karma was already there. Khetraga, jivas are also eternally present, like Brahma. So, this way is going to give argument that from Shastra, different place, Sruti Bhakya, punno papa adikam ... after that na virodho kathanchana. So Vishnu going to give result according to their previous karma fall. Even at the time of pralaya, they are resting inside in the form of seed inside Vishnu. Jasaikani sheshutukala mathava lamba yivanti loma vilaya jagadanna natha. I already told. So, karma anadi, jiv anadi, brahma anadi, not that Brahma going to make some segregation. Variety already there. So, whom to blame? Eternally existing. Karma anadi, eternally existence. Jivas, eternally existent. First and second, middle, this conception coming in this material world. Beginning, end, this, that. This is actually, Bhaktivinoda was speaking, this kind of thing, if we are not going to speak, then common people, they cannot understand. But this kind of conception is not applicable here. Past, present, future. Bhaktivinoda was speaking, by chit samadhi, by the help of your bhajan, you'll have to go to deep meditation of chit samadhi. Then you can realize what is what. Otherwise, beginning, end, these, that, all coming, and there can be so many problems. So, actually, there is no problem, and from Brahma, there is no separate segregation of karma. Eternally, everything present. Karma is also present. Now, bijankura bat, And that fighting I already told, seed is first or tree is first, useless. Because already know, karma anadi, if we understand, somebody can put question, there is no seed, no sprout, but you know, in Shastra we know, Bijankurabhat. Bijankur, first of all, seed, after that tree, this question is obsolete. Is eternal world. First of all, seed, after the sprout can come, or first sprout coming, after that seed. This we cannot, because in infinity period, for infinity period, this Bijankurabhat, this, you know, Siddhanta going on, automatically running. No end, no beginning, no end. You know, in Chaitanya Charitamrita also, I can give example, how Bhagavan Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving example. You can remember the case of Choto Haridas. You can remember the case of Choto Haridas, small Haridas. You can remember. Choto Haridas, somehow, Bhagavan going to set some example in front of us, that's why Bhagavan doing this kind of lila. Choto Haridas anyway, what kind of mistake done, Mahaprabhu knows. Mahaprabhu knowing, is going to give punishment. Not going to meet with him, I can discuss this point, at the time of Nilachal Lila of Bhagavan. But, you know, these topics, you know. Mahaprabhu never going to excuse. No. If somebody going to put this topic in front of Prabhu, Prabhu become very angry. Well, you can stay here, I am going. No, you stay. Don't speak. Okay. I am not going to speak. If you speak further, you cannot find me here in Nilachal, I can go away somewhere. Okay, we cannot speak like that. Follow. After 1 year, Prabhu not asking, Prabhu not going to asking, Prabhu not going to asking anything about Choto Haridas within this 1 year period. Long period, 1 year. When 1 year gone, almost, you know, after 1 year gone, someday, suddenly, Prabhu speaking, hey, where is Choto Haridas? Because nobody wanted to speak these topics in front of Prabhu, because Prabhu was very angry. So naturally they fear. They couldn't speak that Prabhu, Haridas gone to the Allahabad, the confluence of three rivers. Ganga, Jamuna, Saraswati, confluence of three rivers, gone. And with the determination, going to jump into the confluence and going to finish body. Oh, really? Haridas is no more there. Choto Haridas is no more there with us. Follow. When Prabhu going to hear it, only and only Prabhu going to pass this remark, which is just related with our point. Prabhu going to give answer, Sa karma phal bhuk praman. Prabhu uttar dila. Sa karma phal bhuk praman. Prabhu uttar dila. When sevak going to speak, Prabhu, Choto Haridas gone to Allahabad and a three confluence of Ganga, Jamuna, Saraswati, with the determination to get your seva, is going to jump into deep water. He is no more with us. Oh, really? Prabhu then speaking only one point. Sa karma phal bhuk paman. I mean tit for tat. Jivatma going to get result according to their wrong activities or good activities. Prabhu going to speak. That's mean same thing. According to Vedanta Sutta, we are going to get same thing. Also, In Gita we know, na kartitvam na karmani lokasya srijati prabhu, this sloka, you know, follow you this, na kartitvam na karmani lokasya srijati prabhu. In Gita, Bhagavan speaking to Arjuna, the doership, this conception of doership or karma, prabhu not going to create. Karma anadi going on. Gita, this sloka, someday I can discuss. Next, Harikatha. Na kartitvam, this doership, karta aham iti mannate, prakete kriyamanani guna karmair avasa, ahankara vimurartha, ahankara vimuratma karta aham iti mannate. This doership is the main problem of all, you know, main problem, doership. That's why this sloka also we can discuss. Na kartitvam, Bhagavan declare in Gita, I am not going to give their doership. Na kartitvam na karmani lokasya srijati prabhu. Bhagavan speaking, that Bhagavan Krishna speaking, hey Arjun, Vibhu, Parabrahma Paratpara Kirishwar Bhagavan never going to create this doership. It is automatically coming in Jiva. And karma also not. Karma Bhagavan not going to. It is anadi. Automatically they are traveling. This way. This sloka we should understand. This karma, this doership automatically coming. For anadi kal, they are moving. So, whatever discussion written in Brihad Aranyaka Upanishad, all before, you know, there is no starting point, nothing. So already I told yesterday, karma being anadi, it is applicable here for bonded soul. Bonded soul, sometime good, sometime bad, sometime doing bhajan, sometime fall down, this kind of tattva. If a sannyasi taking sannyas, with what conception? Why after that taking sannyas going to fall down? Follow what I say. Sannyas means jyoti. Jyoti means jatno. Jatno means care. Yoti, sannyasi means yoti. Just today, morning time I was discussing Gita, katha ayoti. Yoti means to take care. To take care of what? To take care of seva, so that maya cannot touch me. Yoti always busy with seva. Mahaprabhu also going to give same meaning. Mahaprabhu, after taking sannyas, going to give same meaning. Prabhu kahe mukundo brat, mukundo sevan brato koilo grahan. Prabhu speaking, Prabhu kahe mukundo sevan brato koilo grahan, mukundo sevai hoy sansat taron. Same thing written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. I am quoting from Chaitanya Charitamrita. Prabhu kahe mukundo sevan brato koilo grahan, mukundo sevai hoy sansat taron. Sannyas mean to dedicate fully in the seva of Bhagavan. There cannot be any room, any space of personal enjoyment. Then why you have taken sannyas? After taking sannyas, why you have fall down? Why are you going to fall down? Why? You understand the tatastha position of jiva. Tatastha very secretly, very fine from there. Otherwise, after taking sannyas, why fall down? No question. Follow what I say. Tatastha position. Up to the last moment, siddha avastha when get, then the problem can be, then the problem can go on. All the way in bhajan, there can be problem. Bhakti pat iho kanta ka koti ruddho, ha ha ka jami ki maham karomi. Bhakti pat iho kanta ka koti ruddho. Crores of throne, nail, there in the way of bhajan. Every possibility there, you can hurt yourself. You can fall down any time. Today is good. just tomorrow, 1 hour before, 1 hour before, just 1 hour before. As Jivatma is very good, agree with me, just 1 hour after, began, you know, against me. What to speak about 1 hour, one fraction of second. Because for aparadh, it takes fraction of second. Just aparadh done, then go against me. So, tatastha position is very sensitive. You will have to realize, it's not a question of, you know, explanation. Any amount of explanation is not sufficient until and unless you are going to do bhajan perfectly. To realize this point, very from heart. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, so many things speaking, Baladev Vidyasun, so many things speaking, and from Upanishad, Vedanta, here, there are so many regarding time vectors, there are so many question answer. You are speaking that Bhadrajeev going to, you know, when Siddhi, after Mukta Purush, is going to enter, then a starting point we can find. No. I can give argument. I already told about Billamangal Thakur, still I can, next day I can again quote the Siddhanta Prabhupada Guru Varga, what they speak. Follow. Again I can discuss this point of Billamangal. When Mahaprabhu going to hear Krishna Karnamrita all day and night, do you think Mahaprabhu going to hear any book written by any bonded soul? Or Mukta Purush was bonded before? What is the conception? How we can balance? Whole life Mahaprabhu going to discuss in Purushottam Leela. Whole Purushottam. Without Krishna Karnamrita, Mahaprabhu cannot live. Whole day and night. Written by Billamangal Thakur. And Rupa Goswami Pad going to refer about bonded soul, giving the example of what is the Siddhanta. I already told, but still again I can discuss this point. Now today, one indication I like to give you, only one indication I like to give you, try to think over and again, that suppose I am standing at the bank of Ganga and going to throw one drop of water into Ganga. I am going to throw one drop or one bucket of water inside Ganga. Instantly, when I throw into Ganga, instantly, I cannot separate. Second man, when he is going to collect Ganga water, suppose my water also, what I throw, is going to collect, but he cannot distinguish it separately. He can say, I am collecting Ganga water. Follow, I am giving indication. Scientific discussion I can do next Harikatha. How it is possible? Our brain cannot understand. We cannot go up to that far. How it is possible? Impossible. You know? So, like one bucket of water, if I throw into Ganga, automatically the soul, you know, the flow of Ganga. If somebody is going to collect water, Ganga water. Eternal time factor, eternally present. Follow, how it is possible? That one Siddha Mahatma going to enter into eternal world, then he can trace out his eternal existence there in Golok. I can prove. Goloke shava, sarupe shavar hai golokete siti. Sarupe shavar hai golokete siti. In Sarupa, how it is possible? In eternal love, everybody. It's confusing. It's confusing, we cannot understand. How it is possible, Maharaj? It's quite impossible for understand. It's very, very delicate issue, you know. So still I can go on discussing with a positive hope that if I can realize, also you can also realize something. But I would request you to do bhajan perfectly, only and only Bhaktivinoda Thakur by deep meditation of your Naam Bhajan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Then you can understand, otherwise no possibility. No possibility. Any amount of discussion cannot clarify this point in front of you. Follow. Also, yesterday I was discussing some sloka from Bhagavad. Nashto prayesu abhadreshu nityam bhagavat sevaya. Bhagavati uttama sloka, uttamaha sloke bhaktir bhavati ne, bhavati nashtiki. Nashtiki meaning? My strong. Nashto prayesu. One, when one jivatma in the way of his material traveling, material life leading, somehow, I don't know, somehow, by satsanga, somehow, according to previous life karma fall, I don't know. When he is going to, almost going to erase, nashto prayesu abhadreshu, abhadra mean all dirty things, anartha, when almost going on, when he is going to do serve Bhagavata Sevaya. Bhagavat mani? Bhagavat mani? Bhagavat Bhakta also. Bhakta also Bhagavat and Granta Bhagavat. Both Seva. In that case, Bhagavati Uttamaha Sloke Bhaktir Bhavati Nashtaki. He can surely grow Bhakti unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Because in that case, all Raja, Tama, Kama, Lova, all can go away from the heart of the Jivatma. Cheto et, you know, tatha rajastama bhavaha kamo lova dayaschaje cheto etoir anabidham, untouched. Untouched by, then a heart become untouched by Raja, Tama, Shata, all. Prakita Sato also cannot say. Tada rajastama bhavaha kamo lobha dayaschaja kama krodha lobha all can vanish. Cheto etoir anavidham sthittam satye prasidati. He can get full satisfaction, transcendental satisfaction, aprakito sukhanubhuti, because he can get stability in pakka satya. Pakka satya means not unstable sattva, which is available in the material world. Shuddha sattva. Sthitam satye prasidati. Prasidati means satisfaction. Evam prasanna manaso bhagavad bhakti yogataha bhagavat tattva vijnanam mukta sangasso jayate. Follow. How we can develop bhagavat tattva vijnan? I am giving just indication. You will have to think over and again, try to understand. Next Harikatha, I can try to explain. Yat sakta yo badataham badinam vai vivad sangbad bhubo bhavanti kurvanti chaisham muhuratmamoham tasmai namanant gunaya bhumne tasmai namanant gunaya bhumne vanchakalpaturvasya kipasindhu bhavishya patitanam pavana bhavishnam bhyo namo namo.